of the mistakes that we saw tonight are mistakes that we've seen a lot of this season. I'm just curious where your frustration level is.
Kessel down the left wing, across Cotter shoots, he scores! The Penguins losing skid reaches six.
We need to be better. The expectations are higher.
Put it back toward the line here, side Shifley. Score!
It's a tough league. And if you're not willing to bring it, then you're just going to keep on losing games. Something's got to be done. At what point is enough enough?
Hey, one sec. I'm just going to tell you right now, like, I care too much about this team and you guys as players to watch that and not react. We just think too highly of this group and what you're capable of and the quality of people that we have in this room. We know what we got in here. Let's not allow that stuff to slide.
One tonight, everybody. It's the final act before the All-Star break as the Penguins welcome in the San Jose Sharks.
Here we go, boys. Here we go. Big center.
To steal a line but improvise a little bit on it from the great film The Water Boy. Last game of the year, Brent. Can't hold anything back now. Well, last game before the break, Brent. Can't hold anything back now. Borky, for the Penguins, they have to let it all hang out here.
A 9-day respite awaits, but work to be done first against this San Jose team. Off we go, Penguins and San Jose Sharks meeting for the first time this year.
Come on. Still there, in your feet, Ted.
Sharks still with possession. Vlasic flicks it in deep. Vlasic did not play last night. Right in front, Asamoah shoots and scores. And the Sharks have a 1-0 lead.
Oh, what are we doing? No! Come on!
It's about time for the Penguins to wake up. I think they gotta dust themselves off. They gotta come into this game expecting to win, not hoping to win.
Now shot hit with Letang up the far bottom. Right in front, score, and there he is, Erik Karlsson.
This one stings a little bit because I expected a lot better from the Penguins. That's not good enough this time of year, and I just feel that the Penguins need to be a lot better than they've been lately.
Hey, keep going. That doesn't do anything.
Blocked by Karlsson and ahead for Couture. Looking for 5 points. He fires it in.
Penguins go into an extended break here with a loss, but really interested to see how Pittsburgh handles this next little stretch because it's season defining.
The NHL All-Star break came at a good time for the Penguins. A change of scenery, even for those participating in the game, is welcomed in the midst of a long season.
Sidney Crosby here.
How was the dunk tank?
The dunk tank didn't go as planned.
Look who's about to get dunked.
I didn't really know what exactly it was going to be, but I like the action shooting. They said it was on the beach.
When you have Sid the Kid sitting in that dunk tank, trust me, you want to get these targets down.
It was trouble. The way he hit those first few, I knew it was only a matter of time. So nice. It was refreshing. Good to get dunked there.
This is unbelievable. NHL Fan Fest, Fort Lauderdale.
It's awesome.
Unreal setup.
Stanley Cup champions all around.
I just kind of being wide-eyed, you know, a lot of guys that I grew up watching. It's been a while, but I remember Shanahan and Keith Tkachuk. Actually, the Tkachuk brothers were there. So I remember them being, young and playing mini six and things like that. So yeah, I'm aging myself a bit, but that's kind of what I remember about it.
I want to take this opportunity to introduce to you two of the greatest players to ever lace up their skates.
I think we need one more.
Sergei!
Breakaway opportunity. Put that one in the scrapbook.
even at this age, I'm always trying to get better, and I think that really hasn't changed, to be honest with you. I think the motivation and the passion is still there, and that's what it's all about.
On a weekend celebrating the brightest stars in the game, the spotlight was still on Sidney Crosby. The now veteran looked every bit the part.
Sid, you didn't get the casual memo today, or?
I went the opposite. They told us not to wear a suit at the red carpet. So then I was like, for the game, I'll wear a suit. I'd be the only one well in there. It's okay. 35 and older club, they'll understand.
I'm assuming you saw what Mitch was wearing yesterday at the red carpet?
Yeah.
Mitch, maybe, do you think Sid
could rock that?
No.
I'd like to see him try to rock it, though. I'd like to see that. That'd be juicy.
Nice. I always send Mitchy a picture of my white shoes. I got a couple nice pair of white shoes. Took me a while to get a pair of white shoes, so. It was just one summer, Nate was like, man, you gotta rock the white shoes. I'm like, all right, just got them into the rotation.
What was this for you? Is this 7 or 6 All-Star games?
I'm trying to think. Dallas.
Dallas one sounds like
it. Dallas was awesome.
Yeah.
Chani was there.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Playing in it?
Yeah. I went to Montreal. I was hurt. Tampa, LA. San Jose. Six. Man, that first one that Chani was at, Kachuk brothers were playing mini six outside my door all weekend.
I saw that.
They were buzzing around the whole time. We lost 10-9. Yeah. Didn't have a point.
No.
I played with him and Ovechkin.
Yeah.
They scored, and both times they scored, I was not. Like, I changed in some way. Like, I was just like, oh my God.
I was like in St. Louis. I don't think I had a single point in either of the two games for the 3-on-3. I think I maybe had one apple, and that was it.
Yeah.
From the Pittsburgh Penguins, number 87, Sidney Crosby.
Yes. You got it. Beautiful passing by two of the all-time greats.
I didn't expect to get it back a couple of those times. I was thinking I just did my job, gave it to him. I thought he was just going to finish it, but he was kind enough to send me a couple back. But yeah, it was fun.
Good little D down there, Sid, huh? D's playing down there. I love it.
Here they go again, unselfishly.
I'm excited to get back at it. You know, it's nice to get a few days away. You know, we got a couple days to prepare for our next game, so it's a big stretch run for a lot of teams, including us. And you know, I'm excited for that.
Thanks, Sid.
Okay.
The stretch run is what will ultimately decide the Penguins' season. Every game matters, something the Penguins' two most tenured players know all too well. They also know that the break isn't over just yet.
I can do it. That's the scene. This 5 week, give me rest. We have 30 more games.
What is it, 33 left?
33, yeah. We need 65 points. You think it's hard practice tomorrow?
It'll just feel hard because we're off.
Yeah, I think it. If you, like, you're not skating like 3 days, or like two or three days, it's hard, yeah? Like,
yeah.
You feel like you need like a couple days to practice, yeah? Like,
some guys play Monday. Some teams. They fly home, have a morning skate, and then play.
No way.
Yeah.
One more whiskey.
Hi guys, I hope we all had a great break. I think it's a real good opportunity for all of us to hit the reset button. So, you know, I know a lot has happened here over the first X amount of months, X amount of games, whatever it may be. There were certain things that we probably really like about what went on. There's other things that we would hope would be better. For me, this is a great opportunity coming off this break to just acknowledge that and then move by it. And then everybody has a fresh start, right? So let's try to maximize the opportunity we have in front of us. We still have complete control of our own destiny, which is exciting. And we've got a good group here, but we got to maximize it. We need everybody to stay invested, and we're going to take it one game at a time. We're going to put our best foot forward, okay? Let's get ready to push the pace here and get back into it, all right? Here we go, Teddy. Play.
Here we are with the Penguins in a very precarious situation. Are they a playoff team in your mind right now when they're healthy or not? Do they need to add to this
club? Nice.
Let's wrap it up. Here we go.
I think the next five games are going to be so vital in seeing what direction the team's going to go in.
This team is hanging on to a playoff spot right now by a thread. And in years past, they've had the march of the Penguins, and they've always seemed to get right at the right time. And Mike Sullivan, I think, is the man for that job.
Stay inside the line.
He is going to tactically have them ready to go, but I worry about the age.
The solidification and the kind of being back to the mean and getting back to normal is just 500 hockey.
Center ice.
Hockey returns to PPG Paints Arena as the Penguins kick off the second half of the regular season with a visit from the defending Stanley Cup champion Colorado Avalanche. Nathan MacKinnon on the draw. Puck is dropped. Faceoff won by Crosby. Penguins control. And we're underway. Welcome back from the All-Star break.
Skate, skate, skate.
Anytime the Stanley Cup champion comes into your barn, you get giddy with excitement.
I'm coming down for that little backhand. If I don't get it, I'm just going to keep going through.
Back to the point for Petrie. Right circle. Kapanen picks it up. Head up. Centers in front. Bounces back to Pettersson. In the slot. Cancels. Wrister is stopped by Francouz.
I'm already sensing some frustration.
We got to win that. We got to get that.
Back to Byram. For Nathan MacKinnon. Deal with Pettersson. Takes it in behind. Gonna walk out. MacKinnon in. Fire scores. Nathan MacKinnon. Just hooked right around the net and scores finally on the wrister. 4-on-4 goal. Avalanche a 1-0 lead.
See what they did there? Taves came down, right? Takes our winger down, then he goes back to McCarr, and McCarr comes over, right? But then MacKinnon slides, so they play a lot of, against other teams who do zone. I'm sure it's like a play they use.
Is that a JV or no?
Yeah, one timer. Hey, slide wide. You got it, yeah, good.
Joseph gets it over to Crosby, tees it up, fires, that gets blocked. Byron, feeling the effects of that.
Come on. Got to get to the front.
Sits in the corner, the Penguins with the cycle game going right now. Zucker, power move to the inside, can he get to the puck, diving play, right through!
Oh. Come on,
Malkin, and it's in! Score! We're tied at one!
Woo!
Brand new hockey game.
Better be ready to let the horses run here, because this should be a pretty high octane overtime session.
Crosby leads the charge. Crosby hanging on the feed. Francouz, and he kept it out.
It's in.
No goal.
It's close. It's not in.
It's like an inch away.
From our angle, it looked in.
I went back here.
Oh man, that's close. No.
After video review, the puck does not cross the line. We have no goal.
Well, I always showed it to you. Did not cross that goal line. We will play on.
Blood.
Haley drags it in, takes it in behind the goal. Pass toward the middle, Malkin on the box, feed over, Crosby there, he's robbed by Francouz! Malkin the chance, wrist shot, stop, puck is loose, Crosby was tied up, penalty upcoming against Colorado. The pass, Letang, wrist shot, he scores! Chris Letang!
Out of the way, Tanger! As the Penguins rally, goal late in regulation, kill off the Colorado power play in OT and take it 2-1 over the Avs for a massive 2 points here tonight at PPG Paints Arena.
Obviously, it's a great effort. The PK there at the end in the overtime, great job, you guys. Casey made some huge saves for us there. What we liked about it is we got better as the game went on. Our third period was our best, okay? We stayed with it. It's that stick-to-itiveness. That's what we need from here on out. We're going to be in these one-goal games a lot, so we got to get comfortable in them. We got to be able to keep a mindset that's resilient, so when we're down, we just stay with it, right? It took us a while to get that first goal. We found a way, but I thought the third period was our best. The first couple of periods, you know, they weren't the prettiest in the world, but we were competing. Okay, so for me, it's something to build on. Let's get excited about the next one. Great job tonight.
The building blocks of a season come in many shapes and sizes, but the foundations are built with signature wins, and signature wins are found in the details.
We're going to look at breakouts, we're going to look at D-zone coverage, and we're going to look at rush coverages. I thought we got better as the game went on in the Colorado game. I thought our D did some really good things with their motion and the high ice as the game went on. So let's watch this one. This was early in the game. These are the repercussions when we don't execute.
Unbelievable individual effort from Nathan MacKinnon has broken the deadlock.
I think right now we can play fast, and this is something we've got away from. Okay, let's watch this. These are the habits, these are the details to help one another. This is going to be a really good picture. What I love with this one is just our tenacity on the puck. We don't give many ice to play on. It's subtle, but it's also a mindset, right? About getting into people and being hard in those areas. This stuff here, we got to clean up, okay? And I think it starts with just habits, details, and then commitment, quite honestly, commitment to playing the game the right way.
Penguins back in action after what they hope was a season-altering win Tuesday night in Pittsburgh over the defending Stanley Cup champion Colorado Avalanche.
Let's go.
Rickard Rakell's going to make his return to the pond here. First time back as a visitor. He, of course, faced the Ducks for the first time earlier this year.
That's it.
Penguins with a ton of offensive zone time to begin this game, just over 3 minutes old.
Take. Good play again.
Penguins won the first meeting between these two teams. It's Joseph in the slot. Wow. Rister scores! A dart from P.O. Joseph off the post and in! And the Penguins have the first goal in Anaheim. It's 1-0.
P.O.
Standing out. Both benches, too. Special person, special player.
Thanks, bro. I miss you, too.
I love you.
Let's go, boys.
Here we go!
Evgeni Malkin into the slot. Joseph there. Holt shoots. He scores! P.O. Joseph with another rocket.
Nice shot, P.O.
P.O., I was open!
Don't look now, Evgeni Malkin, 1 point away from 1,200 in his career.
Oh, good play.
Go deep.
It's back to Malkin on the far wall. Inside the right wing circle, down low to Russ, to the backhand, shoots, he scores! Russ puts it to the back of the net, and for Evgeni Malkin, it's career point number 1,200, the 51st player in NHL history to hit that milestone mark.
Hey, Rusty. That's it. Nice, G. Congrats.
83 mile an hour, 50 on the ice. What a shot.
Well, how about those apples?
Hey, but good, guys. We play tomorrow.
In hockey, momentum can change as quickly as tomorrow. And after a tough night in LA, the Penguins were left longing for tomorrow.
Case, how are you? Good.
So see how Jars does today?
Yeah.
If he doesn't go tomorrow, then you'll play.
Okay.
So you guys can manage your nets today.
Okay.
All right, so Tick will be available if you want to switch in and out.
Okay.
Otherwise, take what you need in your net. Okay? Nice case. By share, feel free to take the whole practice. You know what I mean? Don't feel like you have to come in and out, obviously.
I just really like Tick. I feel bad, right?
Of course.
You wouldn't get in at all.
We all love Tick. Just saying, get what you need today. That's why I gave you that information. When you're carrying three goaltenders, there's less continuity. Routines are more difficult for the guys to get into a flow state and a rhythm.
Good boy, Tick.
Tokarski's done a great job, and when called upon, he's got in there, he's done his best. He hasn't been in ideal situations. Not sure. See how he feels after this. He'll check in with everybody, and then they'll make a decision. When Tristan comes back, I think that'll return a lot of order to just daily routines and clarity of mind, and let Tristan and Casey get into a rhythm and a flow. Everyone benefits when there's continuity. We try to do our best every day to make it work.
Tonight in San Jose, California, the Penguins dive into the shark tank known as SAP Center as they face off against the San Jose Sharks.
The Penguins, they got to pick up their bootstraps, man, because they are wallowing around in a wild card spot, and it shouldn't be with this type of lineup that's on the ice.
Well, you mentioned picking themselves up. Casey DeSmith probably at the top of the heat for the Penguins and needing to do that. He'll make his seventh straight start tonight. That ties a career high. Cold Saturday, though, after allowing three goals on 15 shots for him. This is big personally here tonight in San Jose.
After tonight, 29 games left. Giddy up, let's go. You got to put these 2 points in the bank.
Harry R.D., J.P., B.O., P.D., Rudy, there goes Zuck, Teddy, Gitter, Arch, Tuts, O.C., let's go, baby, G-Cap, let's go, come on. Have a start, fellas, let's go!
And we are underway with the Sharks winning the draw, and here at SAP Center.
New Penguins in the vicinity, looking for a rebound. Tired bodies, tipped on goal, follow-up score! And the Penguins have a 1-0 lead!
Nice shift, boys!
Let's give the Penguins a lot of credit on that shift. Shooter's mentality,
yeah, you're right.
From everywhere, from all bad angles, kind of like what they did in Anaheim.
Carlson throws it to Meyer, right circle. Wrist shot, sneaky shot there. Better save by DeSmith as the Penguins clear.
Nice play, Case.
Casey somehow was able to flash the block.
Nice wall play.
Rakell gets it over the line. Gensel picks it up, right side. Drops it at the near circle for Crosby. That's behind it. Back to Gensel, near post. Slams it in and scores. Oh, that was pretty. The magic from Crosby to Gensel to the back of the net. We've seen it so many times.
Oh! Post in, Gensel.
Nice block,
Rusty.
I think it's a game of momentum. When you have it, you got to ride it. You got to try to maximize the opportunity. And when you lose it, you got to try to get it back. We've talked all year about handling the ebbs and flows of the game, doing a better job in those circumstances. It boils down to a lot of the little things, the details, commitment, working together. All the things we talk about when they have success, it's the same thing when we don't. It's the inconsistency of it. And I just don't think our details have been as good as they were there for the stretch when, you know, we climbed up to the tops in the league. We've just gotten away from a lot of it. We haven't been as good. We need to be better.
The Penguins know what makes a winning team. It is just as much tangible as it is intangible. Losses can be as good as wins if the right lessons are learned. Every season is different, but the goal of every season remains the same.
I'm just curious, from the Penguins' perspective, where now will they turn to find a little bit of juice and a little bit of momentum?
Tell you what, man, you still got a lot of runway left here. You can't quit, you know? You just never know when the next game is the game that gets you going, because this is still a good hockey team. It's got to come from within. That's the only place it can come from. It's in that room. That's a better team than we're seeing. I look at that lineup on paper, the Penguins should be up knocking on the Carolina Hurricanes.
There is no such thing as a paper champion.
Luckily for these Penguins, their roster is filled with actual champions who understand what it takes to win.